Now welcome to lecture series on mechanisms. We will start with lecture number 5, intermittent motion mechanisms. Previous to this, we have discussed about quick return motion mechanisms as well as the straight line motion mechanisms. Right? Now, the word intermittent means stopping and starting at regular or irregular intervals. So very often we have a need to convert a continuous or a discontinuous motion of a driver into an intermittent motion, right? It should start and stop at regular or irregular intervals of a follower. We have a driver, right, which rotates continuously, and driven, which rotates at regular or irregular intervals. That is when we make use of the intermittent motion mechanisms. And one such examples of the intermittent motion mechanism is a ratchet and pawl mechanism. So this is what you can see here. This is an example for ratchet and pawl mechanisms. There are two main important things in a ratchet and pawl mechanism. The one thing is a teethed member called as a ratchet, and another one is a pawl. Right? So pawl imparts the motion to the ratchet, and one specific advantage or one specific property of a ratchet and pawl mechanism is that it can rotate only in one direction. Rotation in both clockwise as well as anti-clockwise direction is not possible in case of a ratchet and pawl mechanism. That's one of the property which makes it very useful, right? So you can lock it, right? Once you provide a motion using a pawl, you can make sure that the motion does not get reversed, as seen by an example in which man is trying to lift a bucket. With the help of the pawl, will make sure that the ratchet does not reverse in the other direction. That is what you can make use of. Right, we will see the construction of a ratchet, and then we will see how a ratchet and pawl mechanism is going to work. So we have an arm. So through this arm, I can impart motion to the wheel, which contains teeth, which I am going to call it as a ratchet. There are two pawls. One is called as a primary pawl and another one is called as a secondary pawl. So primary pawl can also be called as the driving pawl. So once I try to rotate the arm either in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction that is convenient to me, right, which is shown as member number 3, it imparts a motion through that. They try to turn the ratchet in the clockwise direction, right? So again, what the duty of the secondary pawl is to make sure that the motion does not get reversed. I am trying to rotate the ratchet in the clockwise direction. So B, right, the secondary pawl at B makes sure that the ratchet does not rotate in the opposite direction. Right, that is how a simple ratchet and pawl mechanism is going to work. The one thing that you see here in the center is nothing but a shaft of the arm. So arm can have both oscillating motion, reciprocating motion, or a continuous rotary motion. Right, my objective is to convert them into a intermittent motion. Right? So as seen in the example, so we can see a small example here of why we require a ratchet and pawl mechanism. So in this example, I have a continuous rotary motion available. We can see a driving pawl as well as a secondary pawl. So I am able to convert a continuous rotary motion, right, into an intermittent motion in only one direction with the help of both driving pawl as well as a secondary pawl. We can similarly take one more example. I have a continuous rotary motion available at one end, the one that you see in the pink color, right? So now I have a pawl here, right? So I am able to convert a continuous rotary motion into intermittent circular motion with the help of a ratchet and pawl mechanism. Most of the time, I am able to rotate the ratchet on pawl mechanism in only one direction. Right. So some of the examples or applications of the ratchet and pawl mechanisms are in the turnstile gate. So once you enter a metro station or any other place, so entry means it should only be entry. If people cannot exit from that place, so in such a case, you can make use of a turnstile gate which operates on the ratchet and pawl mechanism. You can only entry. The gate rotates only in one direction. It cannot rotate in the opposite direction. Such gates are called as turnstile gates, wherein they make use of a ratchet and pawl mechanism. Right. So similarly, another application of the ratchet and pawl mechanism is in spanners or wrenches. Right. So once I want to apply torque to a nut and bolt, right? So if I make use of a spanner, assume that I am going to apply the torque in the clockwise direction. So once I turn the spanner back, the torque gets released. Right. So to lock that, we can make use of a ratchet and pawl mechanism. Right. So it makes sure that the motion or the torque can be applied in only one direction. The moment I turn it back, right, I cannot release the torque. Right. It simply rotates. Right. So this is a normal spanner which I am going to use, which is difficult for the application of torque or for the tightening purpose. So now when you make use of a ratchet and pawl spanner or a wrench, right? You can apply the torque easily. So I am applying the torque, so in the clockwise direction. So once I rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, torque does not get released because ratchet and pawl mechanism works only in one direction. In the opposite direction, nothing is going to happen. So it be the job of tightening or applying the torque becomes extremely easy with the help of a spanner which makes use of ratchet and pawl mechanism, right? So another application of the intermittent motion mechanism is the Geneva mechanism, right? So in case of a Geneva mechanism, let us see the construction of a Geneva mechanism. We have two centers here, O1 as well as O2. Let me consider O1 as the center of rotation of the driver member, O2 as the center of rotation of the driven member. There are four axes here. We will explore the reasons, right? So for all the four axes, we have constructed four slots here, and so that a pin can engage and disengage, right? And we have defined angle beta here. Angle beta is nothing but half the angle turned by the member 2 during the operation. This is the full angle turned during the operation, and half of that is called as the angle beta, right? So now in the next step, there are four slots, right? So the O2 is the driven member. We have given a specific shape to the driven member. The slots are connected and one such thing is left. Now I have to show the driven member. Pin will be a part of the driver member. We will show that. So this is a driven member which produces intermittent motion. There is a slot in which a pin, right, can engage, it can go inside and come back outside. Right. So now this is the complete arrangement, the one that you see one, right? This complete thing is called as a driver member with a pin mounted on it, right? The pin is a projection coming outside, right? So this will be the complete arrangement. So alpha is nothing but half the angle provided for clearance. So this is the entire thing. This is the clearance that I have provided, right? So that the pin can engage and disengage smoothly in a driven member to produce the intermittent motion, right? So this is the clearance for smooth rotation. So half of that angle, I am going to call it as alpha. We can observe that the driver wheel rotates continuously. There is something called as a locking plate, right? We will explore the working slowly now. So there is a slot on which the pin is going to engage. So as the driver wheel tries to rotate, the pin, right, goes inside the slot, right? And the driven member, right, rotates by 90 degrees in this case, right? Since there are only four slots, 360 by 4 will be 90 degrees. So slot rotates by 90 degrees and pin ejects outside, right? So till the other member is engaged, so we see that this portion where there is no engagement is going to take place. So it is called as a locking plate. The entire driven member will be locked by the locking plate. So till the pin on the driver engages another slot in the driven member. That is how we can convert a continuous rotary motion into intermittent motion. We can see a small example here. The one that you find in the red color here will be the driven member. One that you find in the green color will be the driver member, right? So the projection that you see here will be the locking plate. So here is the pin. Once the pin engages, we can just observe here, once the pin goes inside a slot, we can observe that it rotates it by 90 degrees, and this projection, this locking plate, makes sure that the driven member is locked for another 270 degrees, right? Again, the driver rotates by 270 degrees, right? Out of 360 degree motion of the driver, only 90 degrees, right, the driven member is going to turn. So if I rotate the green member by 360 degrees, red is going to rotate only by 90 degrees. That is how we can appreciate the Geneva mechanism. We can increase the number of slots so that we can increase the rotations of the intermittent motion. That is how the Geneva mechanism is going to work. This is how we can appreciate here. So we have to appreciate this projection, which we call it as a locking. So we see that now the driver member has locked the driven member. Now the pin engages, right, and turns the red and disengages. So in that, it has turned the red member by 90 degrees. So 360 degree motion of the green results in 90 degree motion of the red. So that is what we appreciate in a Geneva mechanism, right? So this is a 3D printed Geneva mechanism which can be observed for more clarity. So this one can be called as O1, this one can be called as O2. So this will be the pin, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, there are four slots. So for 360 degree rotation of the driver, driven is going to rotate by only 90 degrees. Right? So this is the process of engagement and disengagement. We can see that the pin is trying to enter the slot. It has completely entered the slot and it has disengaged and it has moved out. And the locking plate locks the intermittent or the driven member so that it can stop for the rest of the 270 degrees. Right. What are the applications of the Geneva mechanism? One such application of the Geneva mechanism is in the movie theaters, wherein we have to show the reels. So reel to reel, when there should be a small amount of time gap, which can be achieved with the help of a Geneva mechanism. Right? We can see the appreciation of a Geneva mechanism here. So you can have a film reel, right? So that the film reel, right? So they can be, we can set a time duration for each frame of a movie. So that's one example. Another example is in a counter. So we can have multiple connection, complex Geneva mechanisms. So we can have yellow, green and blue, right? So for every one rotation, so we can see that when for 10 rotations of green, blue is going to rotate by one for every rotation. So we can see that the green member begins to move. So that is one example. So we have learnt the two types of intermittent motion mechanisms, namely ratchet and pawl mechanism and the Geneva mechanism. That ends the lecture 5. Thank you.